the years that I've spent in green building, the part that's probably been the most confusing, and remains so today, is about selecting materials. And it has to do with not only what kinds of materials you use, but also where to source those materials. So let's talk a little bit about that. One of the things that we want to look at in green building is not only the attributes of the material itself, but where those materials come from, what the benefits of using them are, what kind of an impact they may have on the environment. Now, obviously, there are some things that we'd like to do. For example, we'd like to reuse materials. There's all sorts of usable materials that are landfilled in the United States and around the world every day. So if we could make better use of materials that we've already incorporated the expense and the embodied energy into, that have maybe served a purpose in a building already, and reuse those in some other way, that's a highly desirable thing. But when you think about all the building that we do, both in the commercial and the residential arena, in the industrial sector, in all of the building that takes place, that's a tremendous amount of material. Acquisition, transportation, and the employment of those materials. So let's talk a little bit about that. One of the things that I get asked very frequently is about finding suppliers. Well, fortunately, one of the things that's taken place is the proliferation of companies that actually do focus on carrying at least some green building products, some sustainable building materials, has really grown. There's a tremendous opportunity out there for people in the building arena that we didn't have 10 or 15 years ago. It's still a little difficult to find sometimes in a local market that particular dealer that may have the kind of material you're looking for. And I will have to tell you that even as we're here today, there's not one definitive source, there's not one catalog that you can go to that's going to help you to have a definitive list that will narrow down all the choices for you or rate them for you. You're going to have to do some work on your own. But a lot of this is common sense. So let's talk about some of the specific categories. We think about the building structure itself, the building envelope, how we insulate. We talk about the foundation systems. We talk about the roofing systems. We talk about fenestration, windows, skylights, those kinds of things. What about finishes? What about the parts of the building that we don't see, the mechanical systems, and the things that are behind the walls? Well, let's go into some of those.